mesai kalmıyoruz deyin. Hele sabahlama hiç kalmıyoruz deyin. Bir de diyor ki işte bu kalmayacağız anlamına gelmiyor. Bizimle alay ediyorlar, gülüyorlar.
Usually auditors inform them about their visitings previously 1 week before or 10 days before. And they gathered all workers, including me, in the factory. And we were told that we have to say something about our overtimes. They said us, management said us that we are doing only, please say these auditors, we are doing not too much overtime. We are doing very minimum overtime in this factory. And you, and please don't say that we are doing overtime until morning. And they were also workers also were told that
don't worry, my English is as yours, worse than yours.
And they are also making fun of us because they say just after this verse, they say that this not means we will not do overtime. We will do overtime, but you have to say these and these and these.
Zaten verdikleri para yetmiyordu. Mesai kalmak zorunda kalıyorduk. Ama mesela belli bir şeyimiz geçince de gidemiyorduk yani. Mecburu tutuyorlardı.
We have to do overtime for two reasons. First, they usually force us to do that. But at the same time, our salary does not fit our needs. We are not able to pay our bills and other things. And in order to get more money, we have to do overtime. But we are although we sometimes need to do overtime due to our low salary. When we want to go home, they never let us to go home. This is a kind of mandatory overtime.
İşte yine o şimdi markalar gelince bize diyorlardı ki solventi baleyi sakın göstermeyin. İğneleri saklayın. Kimin yanında yakalanırsa kapıya koyarız, cezalandırırız diye de tehdit baskılardı.
During the audits of big brands, also we have to hide solvents, chemicals and needles. If someone caught with that materials, he or she will be immediately fired, they say us.
İşte bir sürü kötü koşulun sonucunda biz sendikalaşmaya, örgütlenmeye karar verdik. Örgütlenince de duyduğu gün sudan bahanelerle bir astar sökümden, ikincisi yatak asmasından, resmen tuzak hazırlamışlar bana. İki tane ihtar verdiler. İhtarın sonucu çıkışımı verdiler. Ama çıkış deyince paramı falan vermediler yani. Desanın tazminat verdiği görülmüş mü dediler. Nermet Aydınlık'ta duruyor. Sinevi dizini. 144 saat mesai normal duruyor.
For improving these bad working conditions, we have not any opportunity other than get organized, because we don't have any mechanism to explain our problems to the management, and we started to get organized. And although I was known as a good manner and hard working and good worker in my workplace, I was given two warnings in the same day. Until that moment, I have never received any warnings from management. And they know that I was leading this organizing activity. They were informed about that. And they gave two warnings in the same day, and they fired me in the same day, end of this day. and they didn't pay anything to me. Neither my June salary, nor my severance payment, nor seniority payment, nor holiday payment, nor overtime. Nothing I was received from them.
When was that? When was that?
In 3rd of the July in 2008.
Aynı şekilde Düzce'deki arkadaşlarıma da aynısını yaptılar. Hiç onlar da hiçbir suçu günahı yok. Tek örgütlenme sebebiyle. Zaten onlar benden 2 ay önce çıkmıştı.
I was not alone because I was working in the Safaköy factory in Istanbul. There were also workers in the other cities, DESA workers in the other cities. They were also fired due to their organizing activity in that factory in the end of April. 46 workers were fired due to their organizing activity in Düzce plant.
İşte ben orada beklemeye başladım. Beklemeye başladıktan sonra sendikamla beraber bu sefer gel anlaşalım dedi. Rüşvet önerdi bana. 8 seneye işte 8 milyar artı sen söyle. Pazarlık etmeye başladı benimle. Ama ben de bunu alamazdım. Yani bir vicdanına sahip birisi alamazdı. Çünkü yarın öbür arkadaşlarımla da görüşeceğim dedi. Ben almış olsaydım 300 arkadaşım daha kapıya konulacaktı. Onu biliyordum.
After my dismissal, I started to wait in front of the factory with my union. I just demand that reinstatement. I just demand reinstatement of mine. And two days after, they just called me inside of the factory to the management, and they without union participation, and they say that they will pay to me 4,000 euro for 8 years, and I can I was able to save more. But they say that at the same time we will meet your friends in the factory. I mean, this means that they will fire also my friends whom I lead to register union. And I recognize that and I refuse this money because I know that if I take this money, they will fire maybe 300 workers more.